welcome back to an episode of Off the Shelf. I'm Ernestum HD, and this week, what we found off the shelf was...
Is this big enough to be cool?
Game changer.
We just wanted to call one last time. Make sure you were set for the night.
Yep, all good. Everything that shine ain't always gonna
be gold. Hey. Project X, released in 2012. This is a found footage comedy film starring Thomas Mann, Oliver Cooper, Jonathan Daniel Brown, and Dax Flame, who you may know, maybe not all of you, but you may know from the Diary Superman Kid meme. If you don't know it, look it up. But I looked him up, and I'm like, oh my god, I don't know who this is. But then I looked up his YouTube channel, and I'm like, holy shit, I know who this is. It's the fucking Superman Kid meme. And it's like, it's crazy, because also, I liked Dax. He was one of my favorite characters in the movie, even though he barely had any dialogue. I don't know, I'll explain later. But this film was also inspired by the delinquent, you could call him at the time, a lot of people called him, Corey Worthington, through a massive 500 attendance party back in 2008. This film was loosely inspired by it. A lot more people showed up in this one. But I think, like, the ending, like, interview with Oliver Cooper's character, I think was really funny because it was clearly inspired by the Corey Worthington interview. If you don't know what that is, just look it up. It's funny. But this film, I think... Well, it was funny. I think it also was a cautionary tale, you know, even though this did inspire other, like, stupid kids to be like, dude, that party looked sick. I want to recreate that, which is not the point of the movie, right? The point of the movie is to say it's a bad idea to not do this shit, right? Because, like, his house was trashed. His parents are gonna go into bankruptcy. He was fucking taken to court. And he was convicted of shit, you know what I mean? And it's like, just don't do shit like this, all right? Don't throw stupid parties like this, because they always say it's better going to a party than throwing a party, right? Because then you have to wake up the next morning in the same house, so you have to clean everything up, right? Everybody else in the party, they can just leave and forget everything that just happened, right? Because they don't have to deal with the repercussions of it. And this film is the extreme example of that. And I just think it's funny because in the Netherlands, it was called Project X Heron. There was a little town. And I think it's really funny because it wasn't supposed to be as crazy. It was kind of similar to the plot of this movie. So a girl set up a public birthday invite. It was a birthday, just like this movie. And she made it public because she wanted her friends to bring her friends. But then it just spread and spread and spread and spread to the point where there were 50,000 invites, and about, I think, from the 19th of 21st September of 2012, the attendance expectance went for, maybe this was like a second time, it went from 8,000 to 30,000. It was insanity. They had to close down the fucking neighborhood. It was insanity. They used the football field as like a refugee camp. It was insane. Like, I don't know. It was like an evacuation. Right? You get what I mean. But I'm getting a little off track here. I'm just saying that this film, a lot of it was just kind of like chaos and crazy shit happening. Honestly, that was most of the film. One thing I liked about this movie is that it didn't waste time with a setup, right? Because obviously it had to set it all up. But what I liked about it is that, like, maybe a half an hour or like 20 minutes of the beginning of the movie was the setup. And then the rest of it was insanity. Right? The rest of it was chaos, and there was the party, right? Like, we didn't really waste time. Like, there wasn't just a little bit of chaos, but the rest of it was set up. It was pretty much all chaos. That was pretty much the entire film. That's what I like, as I said, that's what I like about it. Because, like, I just have a problem with movies that, like, advertise, like, something in a, like, big's gonna happen, but then they spend, like, 80% of the movie setting it up, and then only, like, the last 20 minutes is the actual, like, big thing that you want to see happen, right? Like, I don't know, I think, like, some horror movies or some even found footage movies work that way, right? Where if it's done well, like the build up, most found footage movies are horror movies. So when like the build up is good, then the last 20 minutes is a good payoff. But sometimes I just like a movie full of chaos, you know, full of just crazy, wild shit that's stupid, makes you laugh. Obviously there were some cameos from this film. Vern Troyer made a cameo. He was very aggressive. He punched people in the dick all the time, and he drove a car into a pool. He drove the main character, Thomas's dad's car into the pool, and he said, "Fuck you guys, fuck your car." He shoved me into an oven, which they did. But it was his fault. He started it. Really, he belonged in that oven. Anyway, as I was saying, there was also a cameo from Miles Teller, who was also in Whiplash. I made a video about that. Go watch that right now. Go find it. It's not that far from here. But, anyway, as I said, I don't really even know what much I can add to this film. There isn't, like, any deep... I mean, there's a message, and it says, don't be an idiot and throw a giant party and ruin your house and burn down the neighborhood. That's pretty much the message, right? It's not very complex. It's mainly just, like, a dumb fun... It's a popcorn movie, kind of. It's kind of a popcorn movie. Because it's just stupid, dumb fun. That's essentially all that happens. Just like it just, the craziness dials up and up and up and up until the, you know, falling action at the end. Which I think is, I think I like about that. Because the film doesn't need, I don't need to watch like a super artsy, super deep, complex film all the time. Sometimes I just want to have fun. You know, sometimes I just want to sit down and laugh at a movie. And this is that exact kind of movie. And I like that. I really think also, I told you earlier that one of my favorite characters is Dax, mainly because, like, he's just, like, there most of the time, and I just have, like, a fascination. Like, I just have, like, an obsession with characters that, like, are there, but they don't do anything. But that's what I like about them, right? Like, sometimes when they do something, I'm like, oh my god, that's the character. That's the character. Like almost a character that almost everybody ignores. But I always am, like, in if they're in, like, the background, I'm looking at them. If, like, a character's talking, I'm looking at that random side character that doesn't do anything. I don't know why, I'm just obsessed with that. And Dax is that exact character. He doesn't talk very much. He doesn't do a lot. He only has, like, one scene special to him, right? It's a little, like, part of a montage, right? He is really just, like, an observer. He's a part of their friend group, but he really only just follows them around and records everything, right? And I like that because... You know, it's just, it's funny, right? To me, he's funny because, like, he's just so good at, like, sneaking up on people and watching people and recording people. I just think it's, I don't know, I just find him entertaining. And I just also find it really nice how literally he's kind of, like, the designated person. Because he doesn't do anything. Like, all the other characters, they, like, do bad shit. They jump off the roof onto a bouncy castle. They fucking do crazy shit. They cause the chaos. They're one of the catalysts to the causing of the chaos, right? But Dax, he just hangs around and records. That's all he does. That's all he does, and I love it. And he has, like, this fucking, like, black sweatshirt, and, like, he has, like, a super black, like, edgy outfit on the entire time. And he, I think, either, maybe I'm wrong, but, there was a scene, like, in a pool, right? And I maybe he wasn't recording, maybe he was just off doing whatever, or maybe he was recording somewhere else, but I just like to think he was in the pool, full sweatshirt, in his jeans, just fucking in the pool recording with his waterproof camera. I don't know. I just think, it's just amusing. Maybe you guys don't understand, but it's amusing to me. I like useless characters. I like useless characters. But anyway, I wanted a bit of a tangent there. Some other things that I like. I really like the, like, 12-year-old security guards. I really like them because they had, like, a running gag of how they took things way too seriously. You know, they were, like, trying to be the best security guards ever, but really they were the worst security guards ever because they were supposed to keep the party in check. Nobody was supposed to get in the house. No, like, they were supposed to make people not go crazy, but eventually people started flooding into the house. Obviously, the house was getting trashed. A lot of shitty things were happening. They were breaking through windows and shit. So obviously security guards didn't do very well. And then there was eventually a neighbor who's like, you guys need to cut this shit out. It's way too loud. I'm gonna call the police. Right? And then, like, he was arguing with them, and the security guard just fucking pulled out a taser and tased him in the fucking neck. And then they, and then that same security guard, or like there was two of them, one of them broke into their fucking house to make sure they don't call the cops, but they did. And it's just like, and then they just, like, it just escalates with those security guards. Eventually, they have a really bad thing out for that neighbor specifically, because there's a part in the movie where, like, everything's going to shit. Like, the party's dispersing. Like, they had a, they fucked with a drug dealer, stole his garden gnome that had ecstasy in it, and he trying to get his gnome, but they broke it earlier. He didn't know that, so he was trying to get his gnome, and he had a fucking flamethrower, and he was just burning down the neighborhood. But, like, it burned that neighbor's tree, the neighbor who called the police's tree, and he's like, you owe me a fucking tree! Like, they have a big rivalry with that one neighbor, like, throughout the entire movie, which is another little side thing, which is funny, the rivalry with that neighbor. And then, at the very end, where they're all running away, they just, the fucking two security guards just tackle him and start beating the shit out of him for no reason. It's really funny. It's like, I think, like, some of the side running gags are some of the funniest bits. Like, the dog had a little story going on. Like, they were trying to, like, he was hidden everywhere. Like the people at the party were just, like, hiding the dog places. They were just picking him up. They spray-painted him. They were, like, they weren't, like, I guess not, like, hitting him or abusing him. They were just hiding him everywhere. Just keeping him places. And it was just, like, there was also a bit of, like, kind of a subtle romance going on with one of the characters, Kirby, and the main character, Thomas. It's also a bit of a side story. It's not, like, a main focus of the movie. But overall, I liked that. I also liked a bunch. There's also a bunch of other side stuff, maybe that I can't remember, or just I don't remember all of it, so I don't really want to mention it because it would be incomplete. But I'm just saying, this movie was fun, right? I know I've said this a lot, but this movie's fun, and honestly, I just think it's a good time overall. It's entertaining, funny, just fun to watch. You can just snack on something, and it's, you can turn your brain off, right? It's a turn your brain off and just watch it movie. And honestly, I would recommend it for that. You know, honestly, if you want to just sit down, get a few friends, and point and laugh at a stupid movie, this is one of those ones. This is one of those kind of movies. And if you like this movie and you're looking for anything similar, they said they're working on a sequel, like February of this year. Dax Flame even said he's coming back. Some of the original actors are coming back for the movie. They said it might have a female lead cast instead, but it did say that the original, like, main four are coming back, so what they're gonna do. I think it'd be funny if Dax was the camera guy again. I don't know, I'm just wishful thinking here. But anyway, as I was saying, sequel, would recommend it. If you like this movie, you have something to look forward to, because they're working on a sequel. And with all of that being said, I think I rate this film a 7 out of 10. And, yeah, I think it's a very fun movie. Would recommend it. And, yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. Share, friends, subscribe, to notifications on, comment below if you liked it. And I've been Runtime HD. Off to throw an epic party. I don't know. I've never been to a party, guys. I'm a fraud.